Well, dyslexia is a complicated diagnosis in that generally dyslexia is used when children are reading significantly below grade level. And dyslexia may be related to language problems. About 95% of children who have dyslexia also have evidence of problems with language development. Many of them have evidence of auditory processing problems, specifically problems processing in noise, and other kinds of auditory processing problems, like problems processing very rapidly occurring sounds. So dyslexia then is defined as a reading problem, but its core is probably something else. And the core is probably a combination of auditory processing disorders and language disorders as well. Dyslexia and some of the factors that seem to contribute to dyslexia both also seem to have a genetic basis. So we have research from Abel Banachek's lab, from Nina Krause's lab, showing that when, from another lab of Nadine Gabb, showing that when children have genetic predisposition to reading problems, that is, they have siblings with reading problems, or they have auditory problems that we don't even know if they're going to have a reading problem yet, but it would be suggestive that they might, you can actually show neurologically that the auditory regions of their left hemisphere are processing differently, are handling auditory information differently, even before they start to read. So the role of visual processing in dyslexia is mired with controversy, I think we could say, because we think of reading as visual. It is. We have letters, or if you're reading an ideographic language like Chinese, you have symbols. And so it would make sense that if a child had trouble, they must have a visual problem. But in reality, what research is showing is that the visual component to reading is very, very small. And visual processing problems, although they can occur and they may contribute to the dyslexia, are not the overriding problem. They contribute to perhaps somewhere around 5% of dyslexia. And visual training itself, if you're going to try to do visual training for dyslexia, there are very specific kinds of visual training, at least right now, that look like they might be helpful. And traditionally, people have used things like scanning and tracking and moving your eyes from left to right. And it looks like what's much more important is rapid visual processing, to be able to handle very rapid changes. The eyes, when we're reading, are doing what are called saccades. They're moving back and forth very quickly and sampling the print, actually, which enables us to read ahead. So that you're not just looking at a word and going from left to right, but you're actually reading ahead to see what might be coming, so that you can kind of anticipate and skip words. And that's a visual processing skill that is tied to very specific rapid processing in the brain in general, and that may be correlated more with dyslexia than specific problems moving your eyes from left to right. But even so, right now the majority of the research points to 95% of the problems we have with dyslexia are due to auditory language bases, and about 5 to 7% are contributed by visual processing.